Hello friends, welcome to Law and GK. So friends, on this channel we discuss the contents of law and previous year papers of judicial services and other legal exams. In today's video, we are going to discuss all the questions of Limitation Act from the year 2010 to 2022. I hope ki ye videos aapke liye badi useful rahengi. So friends, if you are preparing for judicial services, this channel will be very useful for you. Aapke liye bada hi beneficial rahega.
Question number 31, mark the incorrect statement. Law of limitation is bars the judicial remedy, does not extinguish a substantive right, is an adjective of or procedural right, or creates a right in favor of a person. Basically, these are the general principle. The right answer is option number D, creates a right in favor of a person. This is a general principle. Now come to question number 32, mark the correct statement. A debt does not cease to exist only because its recovery is barred by the statute of limitations. A defendant can plead that the instrument is voidable even if his suit to set aside on the ground of its voidability is barred by limitation, both A and B, and none of the above. It is option C, both A and B. Question 33. Good faith under Limitation Act implies due care and attention. It becomes relevant when the question is whether the limitation period should be extended or not, the delay on the part of a party should be condoned or not, both A and B, or none of the above. It is option number C, both A and B. Question 34. Period of limitation means that the period of limitation prescribed for any suit appeal application by the schedule to the Limitation Act. Period of limitation means option number A. This is the right answer. Actually, this is the definition 2J of Limitation Act. And the option number B, the period of limitation computed in accordance with the provisions of the Limitation Act. Actually, this is also a correct statement. And this is a definition of the prescribed period under 2J. Question number 35. A party who prays for condemnation of delay under Section 5 of Limitation Act 1963 has to establish that he is vigilant, no negligence on his part, no lack of bona fide on his part, or all of the above. It is all of the above, and this is a conceptual based question, that he should be vigilant and not negligent, and there is no lack of bona fide on his part. Now come to question number 36. Section 6 of Limitation Act lays down that where a person entitled to institute a suit, etc., is at the time from which the prescribed period is to be reckoned, a minor or insane or an idiot, he may institute the suit, etc., within the same period after the disability has ceased, as would otherwise have been allowed from the time specified in the schedule. So Section 6 does not provide for fresh starting point of limitation, and Section 6 does not prevent the running of limitation but only extends the period of limitation. Both these statements are correct. The right answer is option number C, both A and B are correct, and section is Section 6 only. Now question number 37, where a person is affected by two legal disabilities, or where one disability followed by the another without leaving a gap, then the suit or application may be filed till the first disability ceases to exist, till the second disability ceases to exist, after both the disabilities have ceased. It is option number C, both disabilities have ceased, and it is mentioned where, under Section 6 2 of Limitation Act. Now come to question number 38. If a pronote is executed on 5th June 1945, the last day for filing of the suit will be what? It is executed on 5th June 1945. So the day on which cause of action arises shall be excluded according to Section 12, subsection 1. So the counting will be start from 6th June to 5th June, and 3 years from that, then the right answer will be 5th June 1948. Option number A is the correct answer. 5th June 1948. Now come to question number 39. Which of the following is not an essential requisite of a valid acknowledgement? It must be made before the expiration of limitation period. It need not be in writing. It must be signed by the person making the acknowledgement or by his duly authorized agent, or it must be made by a party against whom any property or right is claimed or some person through whom he derives title or liability. So which is not an essential requisite? It need not be in writing. Option B. Because it should be in writing, and it is Section 18, valid acknowledgement. Now come to question number 40. In a suit filed by the plaintiff, the defendant in his written statement has taken the objection of non-impleadment of necessary party. Despite such objection, the plaintiff continued the suit and the suit finally was decreed. At the first appellate stage, the plaintiff withdraws the suit with liberty to file a fresh one on the same cause of action and subsequently filed a fresh suit. The period spent by the plaintiff in the earlier suit under Section 14 of the Limitation Act is liable to be excluded on the ground that the plaintiff was prosecuting the earlier suit with due diligence and in good faith. Option A is the correct answer. And it is mentioned where? Under Section 14 of the Limitation Act.
Next question number 82. A time bar debt can be claimed as set off, fresh suit, counterclaim? No. ठीक है, time bar debt के लिए suit में counterclaim set off और fresh suit नहीं आ सकता. You can otherwise set off. For example, the bank किसी ने loan लिया, वो time bar हो गया. But if the bank has any FD or any balance in the account of the borrower, they can set off it. वहाँ पर equitable set off हो सकता है. क्या बोलते हैं उसको? Equitable set off. Next is 83. Acknowledgement after the period of limitation is of no effect. During the period होना चाहिए acknowledgement. And where it is mentioned? It is mentioned in Section 18 of Limitation Act. Next is 84. What does the legal maxim sui generis mean? Sui generis means the only one of his kind. So 2 is the answer. Next is 85. A suit for damages of breach of contract can be filed at a place where the contract was executed, where the contract was to be performed, where the plaintiff resides. आंसर क्या रहेगा? बोथ 1 and 2. नेक्स्ट इज 86. इन अ सूट फॉर मेंटेनेंस अरियर्स कैन बी क्लेम फॉर द लास्ट 3 years. एंड इट वेट इज मेंशन इन आर्टिकल और आइटम नंबर 105 ऑफ स्केड्यूल ऑफ लिमिटेशन एक्ट. 4 इज द आंसर. मोस्ट अप्रोप्रिएट चुन रहे हैं यहाँ पर. देखिए 98 क्या कहता है कि एक अनरजिस्टर्ड फर्म है जो क्लेम कर रही है राइजिंग फ्रॉम अ कॉन्ट्रैक्ट अगेंस्ट सेवरल पर्संस. तो जो है ये रजिस्ट्रेशन नहीं है फर्म का. ऑन द लास्ट डे ऑफ लिमिटेशन फॉर फाइलिंग दिस सूट, सूट इज फाइल ऑन द सेम डे. रजिस्ट्रेशन करवा के द लास्ट डे पे उन्होंने सूट फाइल कर दिया. डिफेंडेंट बोला कि भाई फर्म जो है रजिस्टर्ड नहीं थी. तो क्या ये सूट बैड हो गया? वेदर द सेड डिफेंस हैज एनी मेरिट? नो भाई, उसने उसको ऑर्डर में कर लिया ना, रजिस्ट्रेशन करवा लिया सूट फाइल करने से पहले. इट इज रजिस्टर्ड नाउ, दे कैन फाइल सूट. 2 इज द आंसर.
Question number 51. Section 5 of Limitation Act 1963 does not apply to option 1 suits, option 2 execution petitions under order 21 CPC, petition for divorce under the Hindu Marriage Act 1956, or option 4 all of the above. The right answer here is option number 4 all of the above, and it is combined effect of section 5 plus section 29 subsection 3 of Limitation Act, because suits are given in section 5 that it will not apply to suits, and these two are from section 29. Come to question number 52. Which of the following is not a disability under section 6? Section 6 is what? Legal disability of Limitation Act 1963. Minority, insanity, insolvency, or idiocy? It is insolvency. Option number 3. Question number 53. In case of a suit for property which the plaintiff has conveyed while insane, the time from which the period of limitation 3 years under Article 102 of the Schedule of Limitation Act 1963 begins to run is when the plaintiff is restored to sanity. Option 2, the date of property was conveyed. Option 3, when the plaintiff has knowledge of the conveyance. Option 4, both 1 and 3. It is option number 4, both 1 and 3. And it is given where? Under Article 102 of Limitation Act. Come to question number 54. A suit to set aside a transfer of property made by the guardian of a ward by the ward who has attained majority can be filed within 3 years. Article 60, clause 1 of the Schedule of the Limitation Act 1963. From when the transfer of property was made? Option 2, the person in possession is served a notice. Option 3, ward attains majority. Option 4, person in possession refuses to hand over the possession. It is option 3, ward attains majority, and it is mentioned where? Under Article 60, clause 1, under this article only. Next is question number 55. In case of a suit by a person excluded from the joint family property to enforce a right to share within therein, the time from which the period of limitation 12 years under Article 110 of Schedule of Limitation Act 1963 begins to run is from the date of exclusion. Option 2, when the exclusion becomes known to the plaintiff, when the plaintiff makes known his intention to recover possession. Option 4, the date of refusal to hand over the possession to the plaintiff. It is in Article 110. So the right answer here is option number 2, when the exclusion becomes known to the plaintiff. Come to next question, 56. The Supreme Court in collector land acquisition Anantnag versus Katiji laid down the guiding principle for deciding an application under Section 5 of Limitation Act. Principles governing the nature of acknowledgement under 18 of Limitation Act, both 1 and 2 or none of the above. It is option number 1 under Section 5 of Limitation Act 1963. Come to question number 57. The period of limitation for preferring an appeal from a decree passed by a court subordinate to the High Court to a High Court from the date of decree is how much period? It is 90 days and mentioned where? Under Article 116A of Limitation Act. Come to question number 58. Section 21, effect of substituting or adding new plaintiff or defendant of Limitation Act 1963 does not apply in the case of which of the following? Option 1, addition of a new defendant for the first time. Option 2, substitution of a new plaintiff for the first time. Option 3, transposition of the parties. Or option 4, addition of a new plaintiff for the first time. It is transposition of party and mentioned where? Under Section 21 only. Come to question number 59. Which of the following is correct with the regard of acknowledgement of liability under 18, Section 18 of Limitation Act? Acknowledgement cannot be undated. Acknowledgement can be made to a person other than the person entitled to the property. Acknowledgement need not be in writing. Acknowledgement can be made after the expiry of the period of limitation. It is what? See the Section 18 of the Limitation Act and its explanation A of 18 talks about. Option 2, acknowledgement can be made to a person other than the person entitled to the property. Come to question 60. Under Section 18 of Limitation Act 1963, fresh period of limitation has to be computed from the date of expiry of half of the extended period of limitation. Option 2, delivering the acknowledgement, signing the acknowledgement, expiry of the initial period of limitation. It is option 3, signing of the acknowledgement. And it is given under Section 18 only. Question 98, Part 2 of Limitation Act 1963 deals with the limitation of what? Suits, appeals, applications or all of the above? It deals with all of these. Option 4. Question 99, for the purpose of Limitation Act, a suit is situated in an ordinary case when the plaintiff is presented to the proper officer. Option 2, in the case of a pauper when the application for leave to sue as a pauper is made. Option 3, in the case of a claim against a company which is being wound up by the court when the claimant first sent his claim to the official liquidator. Which one of the above is correct? Actually, all of these are correct. And it is mentioned where? Section 3, subsection 2A of the Limitation Act. Question number 100. Where the prescribed period for any suit, appeal or application expires on a day when the court is closed, the suit, appeal or application may be instituted, preferred or made on the day when the court reopens or on the day when the court is closed, within 10 days after the court reopens, or within a reasonable time. It is basically Section 4 of Limitation Act, and the right answer is option number 1 only, when the court reopens. Question 101, Section 5 of Limitation Act does not apply to suit, appeal, applications or all of the above. Well, it applies to only appeal and application, so the right answer is option number 1, suit. It does not apply to suit. Question number 102. Which section of the Limitation Act prescribes that in computing the period of limitation for any suit, appeal or application for a leave to appeal or for revision or a review of a judgment, the day on which the judgment complained of was pronounced and the time requisite for obtaining a copy of the decree, sentence or order appealed from or sought to be revised or reviewed shall be excluded? It is mentioned in which section? Section number 12 of Limitation Act. Next is 103. Exclusion of the time of proceeding bona fide in the court without jurisdiction is stipulated in which section? It is section 14 Question number 104. In computing the period of limitation for an application to set aside an award, the time requisite for obtaining a copy of the award shall be excluded under which section? Under section 12, subsection 4. Question number 105. Where once the time has begun to run, no subsequent disability or inability to institute a suit or make an application strokes it under section 9 of the Act. Option number 1. 106. Section 18 of Limitation Act deals with what? It deals with effect of acknowledgement in writing. Question number 186. In terms of section 3 of Limitation Act, the court is required to consider the question of limitation when an objection on that point is made by the defendant, only if it is not contested by the defendant, if an issue is framed in that regard, or suo motu on its own. The right answer is suo motu on its own.
NC 49, what is the prescribed limitation for filing a suit by a mortgagee for foreclosure reckoned from the date when the money is secured? It is 30 years. It is mentioned in Article 63. कई जगह इसको items बोलते हैं, item number. Schedule of Limitation Act. Next is 50. The limitation for filing a suit by surety against the principal debtor would be 3 years from a date on which the amount was paid by the surety to the creditor. And it is mentioned in Article 42 of Schedule of Limitation Act again. So, भाई 51. What is the prescribed limitation period for filing a suit, compensation for leave and slander? It is 1 year in both cases. So, one is the answer mentioned in Article 75 and 76. And 52, what is the prescribed period for limitation of filing a civil suit, challenging disposition of plaintiff on the ground that land has been illegally acquired by the government? Now, government ne illegal acquire kiya, kya aap case kar sakte ho? No, the suit is not maintainable. Writ petition can be filed if your fundamental rights has been infringed. Next is 113. Section 14 Limitation Act can be invoked for exclusion of. Kya exclude kar sakte hain aap? When the first suit is withdrawn under Order 23 Rule 1 on the ground technical and formal defect, then filing written statement no, dismissal in merits no, dismissal in default no. So, one is the answer. 124. Whether a counterclaim by defendant in pending suit is governed by law of limitation? Yes, it is governed. Who says it is not? It is also a conceptual question and general principle of law. Section 125. The plaint filed next day after the period of limitation will not be barred by time. In which situation? Plaintiff was outside India? No. While suffering from viral fever? No. Advocate of plaintiff forgot to file? No. If the court was closed for a half an hour? Thode der ke liye closed tha, usi time par wo gaya. To theek hai, mil jayega bhai. Section 4 talks about that. Same question was asked in 2018 exam. Same ditto, same question. इसका मतलब ये है कि previous year questions जो हैं वो पढ़ने चाहिए because उनमें से भी एक दो कोई ना कोई question जरूर आएगा.
Answer becomes option number 4, both 1 and 2. Next is question number 12. Limitation for claiming compensation for defamation. It is mentioned where? Article 75 of Limitation Act. And according to that article, the right answer should be option number 3. 1 year from the date when the libel is published. Next is question number 13. Limitation for a suit for compensation for inducing the person to break a contract with the plaintiff. Well, this is what? Article 78 of Limitation Act. And according to that, the limitation period is how much? Is of 1 year from the date of breach. Next is question number 14. In computing the period of limitation for any suit, once the time has begun to run, then no subsequent disability or inability to institute the suit stops it. The right answer is option number 1 only, and it is mentioned where? Section 9 of Limitation Act says that. Next is question number 15. Delay in institution can be condoned under section 5 of Limitation Act in respect of what? Well, section 5 relates to appeals and applications. So the right answer is option number 2. Next is question number 16. The limitation available in law to A for instituting a suit at Delhi for recovery of money against B is till 1st December 2018. A dies intestate on 1st November 2018, leaving a widow, an adult son, adult daughter and a minor son who amicably inherit the entire estate of A. So, option number 1, the widow and the children of any of them can on or before 1st December 2018 institute the suit for recovery of money owed by B to A The right answer is option number one only. Okay, so no need to read out the other options, and it is basically conceptual question. Next is question number 17. A bank has loaned money to B on 2nd January 2015, right? The limitation available to the bank for suing for the recovery of said monies from B. It is what article 19 of Limitation Act? And the right answer will be 3 years from that date. And the right answer becomes 1st January 2018. Next is question number 18. A has, within the prescribed period of limitation, sued B for recovery of debt owed by B to A. The suit remains pending. After 9 years of institution of suit, A assigns the debt for recovery to of which the suit was filed to C. C, after nearly 1 year of assignment, applies in the suit for substitution in place of A. The option one, the application for substitution is barred by time. The application for substitution does not lie as C is not the heir of A. C, as an assignee of A, has the right to be substituted and no limitation is prescribed for seeking substitution. And option four, the suit will be dismissed as A has lost the right to recover the loaned amount. Well, question number 18 is also a conceptual question, and it is related to Section 21, Limitation Act. And there are certain exceptions to that section, and assignment and transposition are some of the exceptions of that section. And option number 3, if we see the option number 3, then this is also assignment here. So this is an exception to that section. Right answer is option number 3. And there is no limitation prescribed for seeking substitution. Next is question number 19. A, on the 9th January 2015, agrees to sell immovable property to B. This is a very long question. You can pause the video and see the whole question. I will read out its option and the right answer only. The right answer here will be option number 2, with effect from 9 July 2015. When the balance payment is given, from that only the time will be started, calculated. Next is question number 20. A counterclaim for the purposes of Limitation Act is deemed to have been instituted. Option A, on the same day as the suit in which the counterclaim is made has been filed. Option 2, on the day on which the counterclaim is made. Option 3, either 1 or 2, whichever is beneficial to defendant or whichever is beneficial to plaintiff. Option 4. Well, this question is what? Is related to Section 3 of Limitation Act. In Section 3 also, it is particularly clause 2, subclause B of that section, which says that counterclaim should filed on the day on which counterclaim is made. The right answer is option number 2. Next is question number 21. The right to access or use of light or air shall be absolute and indefeasible where the access and use of light or air to and for any building have been peacefully enjoyed therewith as an easement and as of right without interruption for how much years? This question is related to which section? Section 25 of Limitation Act. Easementary rights, and the years prescribed in that section is how much years? 20 years. The right answer is option number 4, 20 years. Next is question number 22. A suit filed on the day next to the last date of limitation for filing thereof will not be barred by time. If the plaintiff was outside India on the last day of limitation, option 2. If the plaintiff was unwell and suffering from viral fever on the last date, option 3, if the court was closed for half an hour on the last date of limitation. Option 4, if the advocate for the plaintiff forgot to file plaint on the last date of limitation. Right answer is option number 3, court was closed, and it is mentioned where? It is mentioned in Section 4 of Limitation Act, when the court is closed on the last date of limitation. Next is question number 107. Section 5 of Limitation Act applies to what? Suits, appeal or applications, both 1 and 2 and none of the above. Then Section 5 of Limitation says that extension of prescribed period in certain cases. And in the beginning of the section, it is mentioned that any appeal or application. So the right answer is appeal or application. Section 5 talks about appeal and application. Next, question number 108. The period of limitation for filing a suit for damages for defamation is how much period? 1 year, 2 year, 3 year, or none of the above? Then it is 1 year. And where it is mentioned? It is mentioned under Article 75 and 76 of Limitation Act. Next is question number 109. The period of limitation for filing a suit for possession under Section 6 of SRA is 6 months, 1 year, 3 years or 12 years. Here the right answer is 6 months. And what does Section 6 of SRA talks about? It talks about suits by person dispossessed of immovable property. Then no suit under this section shall be brought after the expiry of how much period? 6 months and against the government. Plus, no appeal and review can be filed here. So what can be filed then? Only the option of revision is there. Next is question number 110. If no period of limitation is provided in the Limitation Act, the proceedings can be instituted within 1 year, 3 year, 12 years and 2 months, and option 4, none of the above. The right answer for this is option number 2, 3 years, and it is mentioned under Article 137 of Limitation Act. Next is question number 111. Suit for arrears of maintenance can be filed within how much period? 1 year, 2 years, 3 years or none of the above. It is mentioned under Article 105. This thing is given in Article 105 of Limitation Act, and the right answer for this is 3 years. Next is question number 112. The period of limitation for filing leave to defend in a suit under Order 37 of a Code of Civil Procedure within how much period? 10 days of receipt of summons or for judgment, 30 days of receipt or 90 days or 120 days. First of all, understand what does this order talks about, Order 37 of CPC. What is it? It is summary procedure order, right? And this thing is mentioned under Article 108 of Limitation Act, Article 108, and the right answer for this is option number 1, 10 days. Next is question number 113. The period of limitation for filing an application for review. Review is how much period? 30 days, 60 days, 90 days or 120 days. This thing is mentioned under Article 122 of Limitation Act, and the right answer for this is option number 1, 30 days of the judgment or order. Next is question number 114. The period of limitation for filing revision petition to the High Court under Section 115 of the Code of Civil Procedure is 30 days, 60 days, 90 days or 180 days. The earlier question, it was asked about review, and here it is asked about for filing revision petition to High Court. So the right answer here is option number 3, 90 days of order or judgment. And where it is mentioned under Article 131 of Limitation Act. You must understand these articles are very important of Limitation Act besides the sections. Next is question number 115. If the defendant is abroad during the period of limitation, such period is excluded from the period of limitation, such period is included, excluded, included, such period is excluded from the period of limitation only if the period of stay abroad is more than 30 days or option number 4, none of the above. The right answer for this is such period is excluded from the period of limitation. The right answer is option number 1, and where it is mentioned under Section 15(5) of Limitation Act.
Ab aa gaya Limitation Act. Question number 6. A plaintiff on account of his illness is unable to file a civil suit within the period of limitation. He files the suit along with an application for condonation of delay on the ground of his illness. Can the court condone delay in filing of the suit under Section 5? Kya Section 5 mein condonation of delay for the suits diya hua hai? No. No, court cannot condone the delay because Section 5 is only for appeals and applications. Alright. And if you want to file an application for condonation of delay of suit, wo kahan file kar sakta hai? Order 7, Rule 6. Next question number 7. What is limitation period for filing a suit for recovery of price of goods sold and delivered where no fixed period of credit is agreed upon? Ye hota hai 3 years from a date. तो ये होता है 3 years on the date of delivery of goods. 3 is the answer. और ये कहाँ पर mention किया गया है? Mention किया गया है Article 14 of Schedule of Limitation Act में. Next question number 8. What is the limitation period for a suit for possession of immovable property based on title? So it is 12 years from the date when the possession of defendant becomes adverse to the plaintiff. आंसर इज 4. ये कहां पर मेंशन किया गया? ये मेंशन किया गया आर्टिकल 65 ऑफ स्केड्यूल ऑफ लिमिटेशन एक्ट में. अगर यहां लिखा होता बेस्ड ऑन पोजेशन अगर होता तो ये थर्ड ऑप्शन आता, दैट इज आर्टिकल 64. नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन नंबर 9, बिफोर द एक्सपायरी ऑफ द प्रिस्क्राइब पीरियड ऑफ लिमिटेशन, बिफोर द एक्सपायरी ऑफ द प्रिस्क्राइब पीरियड ऑफ लिमिटेशन फॉर फाइलिंग ए सूट फॉर रिकवरी ऑफ मनी द डिफेंडेंट एक्नोलॉजीज हिज लायबिलिटी इन राइटिंग एंड साइंड बाय हिम, देन अंडर सेक्शन 18 ऑफ लिमिटेशन एंड द पीरियड ऑफ लिमिटेशन विल स्टार्ट फ्रॉम अ डेट. कौन सी डेट से? जब वो एक्नोलॉजमेंट ऑफ डेट की राइटिंग में हुई और साइन की गई. तो 2 इज द आंसर. सेक्शन 18 ही मेंशन करता है डेट ऑफ राइटिंग एंड साइनिंग दैट. नेक्स्ट इज क्वेश्चन नंबर 10, द लिमिटेशन पीरियड फॉर अ सूट फॉर एन अकाउंट एंड शेयर ऑफ प्रॉफिट ऑफ अ डिसॉल्वड पार्टनरशिप फर्म इज 3 ईयर्स फ्रॉम डेट ऑफ डिसॉल्यूशन ऑफ द पार्टनरशिप, 3 इज द आंसर. ये कहां पर मेंशन किया गया है? मेंशन किया गया आर्टिकल 5 ऑफ स्केड्यूल ऑफ लिमिटेशन एक्ट. नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन नंबर 11, व्हाट इज लिमिटेशन पीरियड टू हैव द लीगल डेफिनिटी ऑफ डिसीज्ड प्लेंटिफ मेड अ पार्टी अंडर सीपीसी. और देखिए यहां पर सीपीसी पूछा हुआ, अगर क्रिमिनल होगा तो इट इज 30 डेज मेंशन इन सेक्शन 394 ऑफ सीआरपीसी, एंड यहां पर कितना है 90 डेज मेंशन इन आर्टिकल 120 ऑफ स्केड्यूल ऑफ लिमिटेशन एक्ट. ऑलराइट, नेक्स्ट इज 12, वेयर द प्रिस्क्राइब पीरियड फॉर फाइलिंग अ सूट एक्सपायर्स ऑन अ डे व्हेन द कोर्ट इज क्लोज, देन द सूट मस्ट बी फाइल्ड ऑन द डे व्हेन द कोर्ट रीओपन्स. सेक्शन ऑप्शन 3 इज करेक्ट एंड वेयर इट इज प्रोवाइडेड इन सेक्शन 4. बहुत ही कॉमन क्वेश्चन है, आता रहता है किसी न किसी एग्जाम में. नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन नंबर 13, अंडर सेक्शन 6 ऑफ लिमिटेशन एक्ट, लिमिटेशन फॉर अ पर्सन हु इज एंटाइटल्ड टू इंस्टीट्यूट अ सूट इज एक्सटेंडेड इफ पर्सन इज माइनर इनसेन एंड इडियट. तो 4 इज द आंसर. ये भी कॉमन क्वेश्चन है. कहने का मतलब ये कि जो प्रोविजंस हैं उनसे जो क्वेश्चंस आए हुए हैं वो तो रिपीट क्वेश्चन होते ही होते हैं, बट जो आर्टिकल्स जैसे पूछे हुए हैं ना ऊपर भी किसका कितना पीरियड है, जैसे कि नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन है क्वेश्चन नंबर 14, तो ये तो डीजीएस ने मतलब ऑलमोस्ट सारे के सारे पूछ ही लिए हैं. जो क्योंकि सारे एग्जाम्स के अगर आप देखें ना, मैंने इसकी अलग से वीडियो बनाई हुई है लिमिटेशन एक्ट की, ऑल क्वेश्चंस ऑफ डीजीएस व्हिच हैव कम इन एग्जाम्स फॉर प्री 2010 से लेकर 2019 तक, तो आप देख सकते हैं. तो वहां पर आपको दिख जाएगा कि उन्होंने ऑलमोस्ट सारे ही जितने भी स्केड्यूल में दिए हुए हैं प्रोविजन सारे पूछ लिए हैं, ऑलमोस्ट सारे, आधे से ज्यादा वो पूछ चुके हैं, वही रिपीट नहीं होते, बाकी सब जो प्रोविजंस हैं जो सेक्शंस हैं वो तो रिपीट हो ही जाते हैं. और देखिए जैसे 14 में पूछा था, पीरियड ऑफ लिमिटेशन फॉर फाइलिंग ए सूट फॉर स्पेसिफिक परफॉर्मेंस ऑफ कॉन्ट्रैक्ट इज एज फॉलो, कितना है 3 ईयर्स फ्रॉम डेट फिक्स फॉर परफॉर्मेंस और इफ नॉट सच डेट देन व्हेन द प्लेंटिफ हैज नोटिस दैट परफॉर्मेंस इज रिफ्यूज. सो 4 इज द आंसर. ये कहां पर मेंशन किया गया है? मेंशन किया गया है ये आर्टिकल 54 ऑफ स्केड्यूल ऑफ लिमिटेशन एक्ट में. Next is 15, a suit is filed by the plaintiff after expiry of period of limitation. The defendant does not set up a defense that the suit is barred by limitation. In such circumstances, the court will proceed with the matter, adjudicate the same on merits. The court can direct the defendant to raise plea of limitation and amend the pleading. The suit, even though defendant has not set up a defense of limitation, is liable to be dismissed. Very common question from section 3. Which is mandatory to be followed by the courts. अगर limitation से बाहर है तो सबसे पहले court को क्या देखना है कि जो claim कर रहे हैं जो वो चीज़ limitation के अंदर है या नहीं, या barred by limitation है, तो defense वहाँ पर लाने की ज़रूरत नहीं है, court को अपने आप ही देखना है. 3 is the answer. यहाँ पर हो गया limitation ख़त्म. अगर आपको इसमें कोई कमी लगी हो, कोई suggestions हो, कोई advice हो, कोई comments हो, तो आप जो है comment section में जाकर भी लिख सकते हैं. We always appreciate your comments. And अगर आपको ये वीडियो अच्छी लगी और एफर्ट्स हमारे अच्छे लगे हो तो उसको जरूर लाइक कीजिएगा, शेयर कीजिएगा अपने फ्रेंड्स के साथ, सो दैट दे कैन कम टू नो अबाउट आवर चैनल एंड वो भी बेनिफिट ले सकें. एंड अगर आपको हमारे एफर्ट्स अच्छे लगे हो तो इन एडिशन टू लाइक एंड सब्सक्राइब काइंडली गिव अस अ सुपर थैंक्स इज अ वे टू अप्रिशिएट द कंटेंट क्रिएटर. आप जो है जो भी कंटेंट बनाता है उसको अप्रिशिएट करने के लिए कोई भी अमाउंट जो है डोनेट कर सकते हैं, फ्रॉम मिनिमम स्टार्ट्स विद 40 रुपीज़. एंड थैंक्स वेरी मच फॉर वॉचिंग दिस वीडियो. थैंक यू.